This is a video of a few different species of large stingrays. Stingrays are part of the fish family and are closely related to sharks. Their flattened bodies are composed of their two pectoral fins joined together at the head and the trunk, with their long tails trailing behind them. These streamlined bodies are perfect for large rays to position themselves inside strong currents, waiting for their prey to come to them. Rays and sharks are cartilaginous fishes, meaning that their skeletons are composed of cartilage rather than bones. Watching these whiptail rays, you might intuitively think that the small ray is a juvenile, staying close to its mother for protection. But that is not the correct understanding of what is happening. What we are actually seeing here is a male whiptail ray pursuing a female. And like some other species of rays, the male is much smaller than the female. The courtship between male and female whiptail rays begins with the male closely following the female, responding to a pheromone emitted from the female. The most distinctive characteristic of the cowtail stingray is the large flag-like ventral fold on its tail. This species is often called the feathertail stingray. Cowtail stingrays have often been found in fresh water. There are a few species of rays that migrate from the ocean into rivers and estuaries for spawning and to find food. Like other marine species that move between freshwater and saltwater, the building of dams has blocked these migrations, adding a major threat to this species of ray. Also, unfortunately, this species is targeted by commercial fisheries as a source of shagreen, a high-quality type of leather. Cowtail rays are now under severe threat from heavy exploitation. These next clips of marbled stingrays give a good view of the stingray's small eyes and the ray's spiracles just behind the eyes. The mouth and gills of a stingray are located underneath the ray. The spiracles are an opening to the ray's mouth and allows the ray to sit on the bottom and take in water through the spiracles. After the ray breathes the oxygen in the water, it expels the water from its gills underneath. I came across this large marbled ray on an early morning dive in the far northern islands of Palau. He was resting behind a large bommy, allowing me to approach closely along the bottom without him being aware of me. He was completely motionless, and after a while I moved even closer to him, thinking that he might be asleep. At one point, though, he became aware of me, and as you can see, he moves into a defensive position, giving clear indications to me to approach no further. Curiosity is an innate characteristic and an instinctive behavior of large pelagic animals. This next clip shows how curious these rays are of divers. A black blotched stingray will come to me three times, each time coming a bit closer. I'm inviting these close encounters simply by staying in one place. So here he comes for the first time, slowly approaching me. So he swam off a little ways, but now his curiosity brings him back for a second time. He came closer, but now he's swimming away again. This is typical of many large pelagic animals, where they'll approach a diver who is motionless, but will swim away and then come back again and again. So he swam off a good distance, but here he comes again for the third time, and he'll come even closer. Here's another example of curiosity of these rays. I was swimming along the top of the shipwreck when I saw two large rays up on the bow facing into the current, waiting for their next meal. I slowly moved closer to the first ray, but he took one look at me and slowly turned away to dive down the side of the wreck. So I decided to see if I could get closer to the second ray. But when I did, he took a look at me and also swam away. So I turned around to make my way back. Here's the first ray coming back to me, as if he was wondering why I swam away in the first place. And here's the second ray pushing his way in front of the first ray. Are these rays competing for my attention? Sure seems like it. In November 2006, I was on board Professor Richard Fitzpatrick's yearly tiger shark research expedition to Rain Island in the far north section of the Great Barrier Reef. This was my second time on this expedition, and once again, Dr. Jamie Seymour was on board. Tragically, just 2 months earlier, Steve Irwin was killed by a large pelagic stingray. Jamie was on board Steve's boat at the time and was still quite shaken from the tragedy. But in a few conversations over the course of the expedition, he ended up telling me the whole story. As a videographer with some experience around large rays, I wanted to know how this could have happened. I know these wild animals to be docile and curious of divers. It is this behavior I want to show in this video. But they are wild animals who behave only by instinct. During the shooting of Steve's documentary, Ocean's Deadliest, he came across a large short-tailed stingray in shallow water. Steve and his cameraman had the idea for Steve to approach from behind and set up a camera shot of Steve hovering above the ray. But by swimming over the top of the ray, Steve blocked out the sunlight, casting a shadow over the ray. The ray sensed a threat from a large predator and instinctively defended itself.